do it. Let's do a celebration. One, two, three.
Yay!
Fantastic. We are in the 2000s. It seems amazing that it was over 20 years ago when the entire world rang in the new millennium with style. The millennium bug did not destroy anything. The new century started on a sad note for the Queen when in 2002 both her mother and her sister died. But after that, there have been many positive events. In 2002, Queen Elizabeth marked her golden jubilee. Her 80th birthday in 2006, and 60 years of marriage to Prince Philip in 2007. There was greater political correctness and health and safety awareness. Conflicts in the Middle East expanded as a consequence of the attacks on the Twin Towers in New York. And the war against terrorism began in 2002 when Britain and the US went into war against Saddam Hussein's Iraq. The global banking situation remained unstable throughout the noughties as one country after another was hit by a financial crisis. The growth of the internet allowed greater and faster communication amongst people. We now see events as they happen from around the world and indeed beyond, including live interviews with astronauts in space. Our thumbs are certainly more exercised now. And they grow stronger with the advent of touchscreen telephones and tablets. In 2004, Facebook was launched. And in 2011, Prince William married Kate Middleton at Westminster Abbey. In 2012, Queen Elizabeth II celebrated her Diamond Jubilee as monarch and opened the London Olympic Games with James Bond.
Good evening, Mr. Bond.
Good evening, Your Majesty.
Grandmother to Prince George in 2013 and to Princess Charlotte in 2015. In 2018, Prince Harry married Meghan Markle. Contentious one. For 70 years. Two of the most important men in the Queen's life were her father, King George VI, and her husband, Prince Philip.
Majesty walking down the ranks of the cadets. And after
he was at Britannia Royal Naval College in Dartmouth before the war. At the back here, in the centre of the screen, is the 18-year-old Philip. He'd been asked to entertain the King's daughters during a royal visit. The eldest daughter, Elizabeth, is sitting along from her parents, just 13 at the time. Afterwards, they play croquet in the gardens outside. It was clear Elizabeth had taken a shine to Philip in Dartmouth that afternoon. But the young princess exchanged letters with Philip throughout the war years, which allowed them, when peace finally came, to pick up their romance.
It's easy to see the radiant happiness of the princess.
And in 1947, they got engaged.
As she and her very good-looking husband-to-be posed for the cameras in the palace.
And the wedding, when it came later that year, was to light up a post-war Britain still mired in bomb damage and rations. And the Duke of Edinburgh was promoted to commander. He took charge of his own ship, HMS Magpie, in Malta. The Duke took an oath to serve his wife, the Queen, for the rest of his life. He knelt before her and swore to be her loyal follower. During the coronavirus lockdown, Prince Philip was moved to Windsor Castle, where this picture was taken for his 99th birthday and another for the 73rd anniversary of his marriage to the Queen. If Queen Elizabeth's reign is to be judged a success, it will be in no small part because of the man she married. In his adopted country, Prince Philip became the joint author of the second Elizabethan era. She is the longest-serving monarch in British history, but at her side throughout was the longest-serving consort.
All too often, I fear Prince Philip has had to listen to me speaking. He is someone who doesn't take easily to compliments, but he has quite simply been my strength and stay all these years.